Word of God. If you don't know your right may lightly become a plight. But these things God is bringing to you today, that everything that is your right, you will receive them. Oh my God, you will receive them. You would have reasons to rejoice. Dear child of God, you would have reasons to be glad. You would have reasons to be excited because God is making an oath with you. He is making a covenant with you, a covenant of his blessing. And he's telling you, all that are rightfully yours, you would begin to receive them in the mighty name of Jesus. The word of God in Isaiah 45 verse 25 says, in the Lord will all the seed of Israel get their rights, and they will give glory to God. He said, in the Lord, you would get your right. What are those things that are rightfully yours, that for years you have not seen? Yes, you had worked, you had labored, and the scripture made clear that your labor, everything that you have done, you will receive the reward. And up until now, you have not seen the reward. I want you to know today that that blessing is coming. It says, in the Lord will all the seed of Israel get their right. What is rightfully yours is coming to you in the mighty name of Jesus. And you will not struggle for them. Dear child of God, you will not struggle because it is time for you to possess your possession. You see, when the Lord brought the deliverance, there was a turnaround and the people of God began to possess possession. It is time to take what is yours. It is time to take what is rightfully yours. Yes, every blessing that are meant for you, that God wrote your name upon them, saying, this is for my child, this is for my son, this is for my daughter. And for so long a time, you have not received them. Dear child of God, be in expectation because it is time for you to receive the blessing. Yes, you have labored, you have served, you have worked, you have done so many good, and at this point in time, you have become weary. Dear child of God, the word of God says, do not be weary in well-doing, because in due time, you would receive your reward. And I have a good news for you. Your due time has come. Yes, that set time for you to be favored has come, and you'll be able to go to God rightly and say, look at me, look at my work, look at what I have done. Like Hezekiah went to God and he knew he had a right to receive from God for the things that he had done. And God indeed blessed him. God indeed visited him and turned his life around. Just like Jabez would go to God and prayed and cried to God, and God looked upon him with his eyes of mercy and enlarged his coast. Dear child of God, I want you to know that your time has come. Your time to be blessed has come. And he said that it is your right. What are rightfully yours will come into your hands, my God. Yes, the honors that are meant for you, the things that were meant for your family, that for so long a time people have sat upon, today they'll be coming to you. Yes, you were unrecognized for a long time. You have gone without recognition because people sat upon your blessing, because the enemy brought an evil veil upon your life, because you had been masked for a long time and you couldn't receive your blessing. Yes, it is time for you to receive what is yours, and you would walk into your liberation, you would walk into your blessing, and you would dance all the way in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, you would rejoice because God have settled you, because God have made everything good in Jesus' mighty name. Isaiah 45 verse 23 says, by myself have I taken an oath, a true word has gone from my mouth and will not be changed, my God. He said, this word is a true word and nothing will change it. God is saying to you, go and get what is yours. It is time for you to receive them. It is time for you to get them. It is time for you to gather everything that are meant for you. He says, go to me and I will answer you. He says, come and I will give you everything that you have sought after. Every single thing will come into your life. Every single thing will come into your family. And only in the Lord would you be able to receive this right. Dear child of God, what are rightfully yours? Begin to mention them. Yes, get a pen and a paper and begin to list them. Tell God, it is my right to get these things and write it down. It is my right to be married. Write it down. It is my right to carry my own children. Write it down. It is my right to live in my own home. Write it down. It is my right to have everything I want in surplus. Write them down, dear child of God. It is my right to have every single thing I want that I've asked of you, because you said when we meet this requirement, you shall give them to us. And I've met those requirements. I want to assure you, God will make sure that you get them, because it is only in the Lord that you can overcome. It says only in the Lord will Jacob overcome and be strong. Together, all those who were angry with him will be put to shame, my God, and come to destruction. Yes, those people who have been angry with you, yes, they did not want you to succeed. They fought you night and day. He said, only in the Lord can you be overcome. And because they were angry with you, because they did not want you to see good things happening around you, he said they will be put to shame. So you should go to God and say, God, I have trusted in you. I've had faith in you. And you made me to know in your word, in Romans 10:11, that the people that have faith in you, people that trust in you, the people that believe you, you said they will not be put to shame. I believe you. I trust in you. I've put my faith in you. And you said I will not be put to shame. So I want to see those enemies being put to shame from today on, and they will be put to shame. He said, in the Lord will all the seed of Israel get their right, and they will give glory to him. Dear child of God, it is time that you begin to set yourself to give glory to God, because your mouth will sing praises. Yes, your mouth will sing in adoration to God, because he is bringing every of your enemies. Yes, those people that have risen against you, that were fighting you, they were fighting your business, they were fighting everything you were building. He says, as you mention the name of Jesus, every one of them will fall to their knees. Yes, they will bow down to you. That demon will bow down. Yes, that circumstance, that challenges, everything you can think of. He said, they will bow down, because it is time for you to get what is yours. It is time for you to get the things that you have labored for. It is your right. Dear child of God, do you know your right? Because if you do not know your right, it can be taken from you without knowing. If you do not know how to pursue your right, it may end up becoming a plight. But I know for sure, from this day on, the things that were meant for you, the things that were meant for your family, the things that you were meant to enjoy, will not become the reason you'll be in sorrow, will not become the reason you'll be in pain, will not become the reason you will be crying, in the mighty name of Jesus. Rather, they will be the source of your joy. Rather, they will be the source of your celebration. Rather, they will be the source of your excitement. He said you will give praise to him. You would have a reason to dance. You would have a reason to rejoice, in the mighty name of Jesus. So just go to God now and say, Father, these are the things that are due me. These are the things that are due unto my family. I want to see them begin to come. He said, in that time when it is due, it will come. It will happen just as he had spoken it. And you have entered into that due season, that time that your blessings are due. Yes, every of your blessings are matured, and it is time that they begin to come. Every of your investment have matured. It is time that they begin to come. It is time you get the return of investment on everything that you have done. Dear child of God, you will see the blessings of God, the overflowing blessings of God, and this will wipe away every tears from your eyes, in the mighty name of Jesus. You will dance again. You will celebrate again, because you are getting your right. Everything that are meant for you, everything that are truly yours, you are getting them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I'm rejoicing to God because of what he's going to do, what he's going to do for your life and for your family, and your testimonies will be unending, in the mighty name of Jesus. It will continually flow in. Yes, like mighty rushing waters, your testimonies will continually flow in, in Jesus' mighty name. It is done. It is settled, because it is your time to be blessed in Jesus' name. It is well with you, beloved. God bless you and shalom.